Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity of coming here to speak about Kopinor's bookshelf project. That is a project by the National Library of Norway, where my organization, Kopinor, has provided the rights. And I think it's a very good example of licensing, and that licensing is a good solution for making cultural heritage available on the internet. I'd like to start a little with just putting a few words up on the screen, because internet as a still rather new medium, of course, has an economic side of it. And the question has been raised several times before today, who should really gain the profit on the internet? I won't go into depth with this, but here are four lines. I must, as an author myself, state that I have a strong belief in copyright. I think copyright will work also on the internet in the future. I think copyright is the solution, not the problem in many ways, but of course we need some help from the lawmakers in order to make it work also in the future. Because the whole economy of culture, and I'm talking about professional culture now, the notion of professionalism and amateurism is getting difficult with the internet. But the economy of culture is based on copyright, and of course, internet is a channel for creative works. And if there is a professional creation, there has to be an economic outcome somehow. And exploiting creative content means that someone will have to take up the bill. And I will elaborate a little more about this when I come to the bookshelf. Well, first a few words about my organization. We are a collective management organization founded in 1980. That was when the photocopying machine was the new technology. And we were founded as a solution to the problem at that time. And today we are a well-established organization, also licensing the digital use of works at a quite low administrative cost and with a quite high distribution of revenue to the rights holders. So here's the historical fact. You can see it was an immense success. In the beginning, but also for the last 4 or 5 years, our income has increased, not the least because we have been licensing digital works, and not the least because also the bookshelf project is part of our income in these last years. I must use just 1 minute to tell about our legal model, because that is the basis of it all, and I think it's important that you understand this. The extended collective license is a licensing model, a part of the copyright law in all the Nordic countries. It's gaining increased attention at these times, not the least because it has some solutions to licensing on the internet that is quite tempting to other countries. Great Britain has introduced the extended collective license. Other European countries are considering to introduce it, and also in the United States, there's a gaining interest for this licensing model. In basic, it means that when an organization like Kopinor, approved by the Ministry of Culture, enter into a license, also the works of non-members will be included in the license on the same terms as for members. I'll try to describe this in a graphic term. Well, this should be a four-step presentation, but it hasn't survived. Okay, it's the organized right holders on the bottom left, that is my organization, Kopinor, entering into an agreement with a user on the right, which, for example, could be the National Library of Norway. Then, of course, we represent all types of authors and publishers of books and other material, but there are also quite a few who are not members of our organizations. These are on the top left of the screen, and then the law comes in to make sure that the license also will include the works of non-members, which is quite important, so the National Library can use any book in the world, in fact, but at least published in Norway. It doesn't have to be by members of Kopinor. So now to the bookshelf project, which really is, I think, quite unique internationally in its part. it is an agreement making the possibility of 250,000 protected, copyright-protected books freely available on the internet. And the agreement was, well, it's 2 years old now. And Copinor, my organization, we represent the rights holders. The extended collective license applies so that any book will be included in the agreement. And it's a solution where it's a quite streaming-like solution so that all these books can be read on screen. Quite technically impressive project, but unfortunately not here in Poland. Since our legislation with the extended collective license applies only in Norway, we did not dare to open the bookshelf for the whole world, but we're working now to open it at least for the other Nordic countries with the same legal model. And if you are to introduce the extended collective license here in Poland as well, we might even open it for Polish Polish users. But it's mostly in Norwegian, so I don't think it will be very much used. And then we get the money, a price per page, approximately 4 euro cents per page. That should be 0.15 zlotys, I think, per year displayed by the National Library. It was launched 2 years ago. And as I said, all books published in Norway, and we set the limit to 2001, all books published before 2001 will be there. And the National Library is scanning and scanning and scanning all the time. So right now there are 160,000 books available, and by 2017 all the books will be there, 250,000. A rights holder, an author or a publisher may opt out, that means remove a book from the bookshelf, but so far it's been less than 3% of the percent, I think it's close to 2% of the books that has been opted out, so the vast majority of books are there and they will remain there. It was part of a pilot project, but it's now a permanent project, and it will bring rights holders an annual revenue of approximately how much should that be? That should be a little more than 7 million zlotys per year. This is the long tail. In fact, these are the number of books published each decade in Norway from 1900 and until the 1990s. And as you see, there are quite a lot of books there. And from the last decades, there are also books that are commercially available. The publishers, most of them have left the books in the bookshelf, so you can either read it in the bookshelf or you can buy it in the store. And it doesn't seem like the bookshelf inhibits the sale of the books. On the contrary, it's a good advertisement channel for the written books. People still seem to prefer the written book. So this is what I call an example of the cultural circuit. On the left-hand side, there are authors and publishers, the rights holders, that enter into agreements with the users on the right-hand side that provide money for the authors and publishers and make them able to write more books, more works to the benefit of all, and to publish more books to the benefit of all. And it has to do with what I said at the outset. Copyright is part of the economy, it provides professionalism, and the authors and publishers should be part of the economy also in the digital era. And collective management, which I represent, is a way of getting seamless access to a large number of copyright-protected works. It is convenient, fast, innovative, cost-effective, simple, and safe, and it provides money for the rights holders as well. Well, this was very small type. It's been diminished. It says, strengthening copyright helps create wealth, employment, and economic growth. The copyright really fuels the digital economy. It's not the opposite. It does not inhibit the digital economy. It is a prerequisite for a digital economy. And I think the bookshelf is a good example of a way of solving a problem by licensing, by entering into an agreement with the rights holders, rather than what many other libraries would try, trying to use as many works as possible without the permission from the rights holders. So with these words, I will say licensing is the solution. Copyright is the solution, it is not the problem, and thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much.